So what's up, guys? Here's the Mike's Brush Care Package giveaway. We're giving away an Awila Revolution CR. We're giving away two Mike's Brush stencil kits, two snapback hats so you can customize in your own time, 5 sheets of white and 5 sheets of black cardstock paper so you have something to practice on. We're giving away one Spider-Man painting to go along with all that so you have some inspiration to hang on your wall while you're painting. Createx has decided to help us out with this giveaway. They're throwing in 1 2-ounce primary paint set for the lucky winner. HD Stencils has also stepped up, and they're going to send you a 3-stencil package worth over $150 for you to get good at airbrushing right away. So even if you've already entered, make sure you check the link again. There's new ways to enter. Make sure you get all those finished up. Get all your extra entries in. This is all possible thanks to you guys. Thank you guys for all the support. Thank you guys for watching the videos. If you like watching the videos and want to see more like this, make sure you hit like, subscribe, and consider joining the channel as a Skull member and get those exclusive perks only available to channel members. I don't know when I'm going to do this giveaway again, so make sure you go and you sign up now for a chance to win the care package of a lifetime. It could be your way to getting your airbrush skills boosted up. Thank you to Createx Colors for helping out with the giveaway. Thank you to HD Stencils for helping out with the giveaway. Thank all you guys for watching and all the support that you guys show to this little airbrush channel. So good luck to all of you. We'll see you guys June 10th when the winner gets picked. Later. What's up, everybody? Yo, what's up, Justin? What's up, Dennis? What's up, Piedra? Saludos. What up? All the Skull Squad. Anybody watching? All right, everybody's here. Oh, man. So here we have what we're gonna do today. Can you guys see those lines? You can see them a little bit. So we have the boots, we have the gun, we have the helmet, and we have our airbrushes, and we're gonna start going ham. So we're gonna work it low and slow today. Low and slow. So you guys can hear me good, I hope. Let me turn down this music a little bit. It's loud in my ears. Right on, Dennis, back at work. Hell yeah, man. That's good that you're back at work, dude. Get back to work, son. Make that dollar, son. That's some Vice City cruising music, yeah. Airbrush real quick, and then we're gonna mix up some gray using the illustration white and the illustration black. I'm gonna mix those up together. probably more white than black.
Alright, so here you guys can see, I'm going to do some white, like so. I'm going to do black, like that, just a few drops. I'm going to do a reducer, like this. Almost like the same as the white. Then I'm gonna put the lid. Then we're gonna shake it, shake it. Hola, Cristian. Saludos. ¿Por qué la gente en español solo llega a decir saludos? ¿Por qué nunca preguntan algo? ¿Por qué nunca me dicen qué les pasó? ¿Por qué nunca explican el proyecto que están haciendo? Nada, nada más. Hola, saludos. ¡Ah! There's somebody next door. They're barking like somebody. That door doesn't have that window. You can look out that window now. You could open it too if you want right now. Mixed up the gray there. Take off that front. And we start working on with the boots, because the boots are going to be mainly gray. We're going to try to get all this in here, and then we're going to work in a background. And we'll try to figure that out when we get there. They start barking right when you stop looking, huh? Well, you should feed them real quick. I should have done it before I started this. That'll probably shut them up for a while.
No, the way Cookie's barking though is like something's out there. You don't just bark like that. I don't know.
I hope somebody's back there taking all the scrap. What's up, Callie Hart? How's it going? Hello, hello. Just gonna give myself a little more pressure there. There we go, that's a little better. Some reducer. What's up, Milan? Hola, Louis. Did you finish painting the house? This guy, oh my gosh. Bro, I started, and then, you know, I started because I didn't have much work, right? It was like slow, so I was like, well, in my downtime I could do this. Yeah, I started the house, and then it was like everybody and their mama decided they want some. So I haven't got much done on the house. So no. But I knew going in it was going to be a long process, because it's not just like paint the house. Like, it's like scrape the house, re-caulk the house, you know, make sure all the seals are good, because it's a really old house.
and the paint job that's on it is like probably 30 years old or something. So a lot of stuff is cracking, like falling apart, and like the wood needs sanding. So yeah, I knew going in that it was not just a 1 week process or a 1 month process. I knew it was going to take a long time.
There is a bunch of lint outside.
A bunch of lint?
Like from the dryer.
Oh, like it spat something out or what?
Yeah.
Oh, no.
Well, that's what it sounded like when it stopped spinning on me. It sounded like it got clogged.
Not that sun though. Anything but that sun right now. That's like not even. What?
I said, oh yeah, nobody found my stash.
What stash?
What the hell? Give me one of those. You should make coffee.
Coffee sounds good. Quiet today in the chat. Punk, where's mine? What's up, David? Chinny, what's up? Thank you. Thank you for watching. What's up, Bobby? Heading off to work, huh? Must work the late shift. Bobby, that's good, man. Glad I could help. Thank you, Chinny. Lots of practice, that's all it is. Thank you. Is that all black and white? Our more colors? So I plan to just do it all black, gray, and white. So this is all gray, as I showed in the beginning. I mixed up some white, added a little bit of black, and that made this nice gray. And now what I'm gonna do is set this aside. I'm gonna take the SOTAR 2020 here, and I'm just gonna mix up some black. This is the Createx Illustration Black, which is already pretty fine in the bottle, but when you add a little bit of reducer to it, it just flows ever so smooth. So that's what we're doing. So how was everybody's Memorial Day weekend? Why was that hard to say? But then I said it like a radio announcer, all good. How was everybody's Memorial Day weekend? Yeah, I don't have to yell. I feel like I have to yell, the microphone's all far. So how's everybody's Memorial Day weekend? Was everybody have fun? Did anybody go out? Anything interesting happen to anybody? Just airing it out in a shop. Airing it out in shop. What does that mean? Like airing it out. Like you were just chilling at the shop, just hanging out.
She already came and stole another cookie.
Huh? She already came and stole another cookie. Yeah, she's, what? Just like those cheese chips, her and Isabel were just like, they were just disappearing. Coffee.
Alright.
I don't hear you. You want that Iwata? This is not an Iwata though, this is a Badger.
What are you giving away in your giveaway?
An Iwata.
Oh, that's what he wants.
Oh, he wants the one in the giveaway? It was supposed to show up today, but it didn't show up, probably because it's Memorial Day. But I don't know why they would estimate or like say that it's gonna arrive today. It literally said it was scheduled to be delivered today, and then it just never made it. Yeah, the contest airbrush, yeah. between illustrations and colors to the regular colors. So, I'm not sure if what exactly is the difference. Because I know it's more than just how it feels out of the bottle. But to me, that's all the way, only way I could explain it. Right, is how it, the way it feels to me. And I would explain the illustration colors to feel a lot smoother. Just out of the bottle, they feel a lot smoother. That's the best way I can describe. They just feel smoother. I'm not actually sure if there is like a chemical difference or not, like there is between the auto air and the regular ones or whatever, you know, but from what I could tell, it just feels to be a lot smoother. Yeah, I've never had a problem with Amazon either. That's why today it was like weird. It doesn't show that it's delivered. It just shows that it showed up to the shipping facility. But usually, like, they're on the ball. Usually when it says the day, you know, that's why I was confident in saying it in yesterday's stream. Because usually when, you know, it says, like, they're on that. Amazon don't play with their shipping estimates. Is it coming or what?
Yeah, it's imported.
No way. It's yeah. Still on the way.
I told you it's fast by 9 o'clock.
Oh my gosh. I wouldn't expect them to send two trucks though, because the one came already. So I didn't think they would send another truck. Just like, oh, we forgot this package. Mm-hmm. I guess they're on it. So who knows? Maybe it'll show up while I'm streaming. What cleaner am I using in the spray bottle? So it usually in that spray bottle is just soap and water. That's all it is. I've said that lots of times. I just use soap and water for flushing out. If you want something to clean your airbrushes with, because somehow you let your airbrush get nasty and dirty or something, which you should never do. Do not let your airbrushes get nasty and dirty. You know, you're supposed to clean them out right when you're done using them so they don't get ugly. But if you do let it get ugly, I have a video coming up using this, which is supposed to, look at what it says right on the bottle. It says, dissolves hardened and dried paint. So we're probably going to try this. We're going to make an experiment in order to get this kind of tested and see how well it actually works. So. Yeah, always clean your airbrush out. Yeah, Amazon, man, they don't play. Boots. Look at them nice boots, man. Ooh. All right. And last but not least, we're gonna mix up a little white. You know, you all know how we like that white around here. We like that white meat. Oh, there it is. Oh no, that's the lady for the shirt. No, she's just dropping it off. What's up, mole? Yeah, I had it sketched out. It's kind of hard to see. Even on my screen, so I don't blame you. Oh wow, the delayed doorbell. You've cleaned them with Fantastic. Does that work? Yeah. Violet. Now we do some white on him. We do some white. Huh? Yeah. She said, mm-mm.
Come on.
That's
dog.
Funny. Can't keep adding stuff once I'm already started.
Wow.
It's not gonna work. So there's that.
That's all she said.
Okay. You should put it over there with that thing. There's no air Todd today. There's no justice. There's no James. Dennis said he's at work. Which I'm glad he's back at work. Cause he said it was getting tough without work, so I'm glad he's back at work. Alright.
here we go on this. Now, to be fair, I sketched it out, but my sketch is pretty bleh, because I just, like, did it real quick in, like, a few minutes, right? I just kind of did the outline of it and gave myself a pretty good, you know, outline. That's all I did. Now, like, I have to do all these details on the gun and all that, and all that's not there. So I'm kind of freehanding all that in, and I'm going to do my best here, so... Yeah, you want the Iwata? Yeah. It's a nice airbrush. Good luck. Does that package still say it's on its way? I don't believe. Thank you. I keep thinking in my head right now is like, how gangster would it be to own a gold, like a gold or a chrome, like all chromed out M16? Would be so sick, not gonna lie. What's up, Stephen Ward? How's it going, man? Why don't you use the Pache Talon? I use the Pache Talon for lots of stuff. I literally used it yesterday for the project yesterday. We use it like almost every day around here. Today I'm only using three colors, and that's what I decided to use today, is these three. And usually I just pick one particular airbrush and we run through the whole project using that airbrush. But today, because I'm doing it section by section, I decided to mix up three different shades. You know, makes it easy. But yeah, we use the Talon every day, dude. Actually, this is like the first time I used a Sotar in a while, so the correct question would have been, why don't you use a Sotar more often? What's up, Ron Chorus? Thank you, sir.
Yo, yo, what up, James? 12,500 Mexican pesos. I don't know how much that is. Good luck with that. What's up, James? Look at them skulls. Oh, hell yeah. What's up, David? Thank you, sir. Yo, yo, what up, Dawa? You gonna be ready for some Tarkov today? Some Tarkov, son?
Now your ship just got delayed.
Huh?
Now it just got delayed.
Oh, now it's delayed. I told you. Till tomorrow, huh?
Tomorrow or the next day.
Aw. They would do that.
Yeah.
Tomorrow? 20 megabytes down is enough to play, bro. You can play with that. Tomorrow, all right. Yeah. Yep, Piedra, it's look. Nothing but practice. Ooh, that's pretty. I like that. Matches your cup here that you're making me drink out of. Mm-hmm.
Hey, your coffee will stay hot in that cup.
You didn't make yourself in a coffee? Steven says, hey, babe.
Hello. I'm busy.
She's busy doing her nails again.
Again.
We did her nails in Tequila Rose Candy yesterday. Sure. It was not good enough for her. She said, the color is weird.
It was fucking weird. It was gold.
It was gold. What's up, Sammy? Hello, hello. Yeah, dude. Yeah, I don't know, dude. If she asks about it, I'm gonna feel a little weird.
She's gonna not ask about it.
Oh, Rar's already on the no bandwagon, so. He's over on Twitch.
Can he see that?
I think so. I don't know.
Yeah, because it goes to Twitch also. Of course he's over on
Yeah, I don't think she'll come this way, dude. I'm pretty sure she knows where you're on your side. We taking sides, bro, and we waving that dower flag. Them dower bills rain down upon us. Did you get it better now?
Yeah,
show me what you did.
Well, that looks cool. Yeah, that looks good.
Can they see that?
There you go, it's perfect now.
Well, it took 3 days. I couldn't go to work with ugly nails.
Air Todd has arrived. The Todd Scoot! The Todd Scoot is here! Run and hide! The Todd Scoot. How am I liking the 2020? I think it's alright. It's alright. It's an okay airbrush. I prefer the velocity to it, honestly. I don't know what it is. They spray about the same. The velocity has a bigger cup, and it's not as what is, I would say the word is, it just doesn't get as clogged as easy. It has a little bit, you know, bigger hole. Try to put it as nice as I could.
And actually, the review for that goes live for everybody on Thursday or Friday this week. This week sometime, everybody gets their hands on that review. And, yeah. That review is going to be... I think it's going to be polarizing, man. I think a lot of people are going to come in and hate on what I said. But I stand by what I said, and I do think that we should uphold companies to a little bit higher standards on everything, right? Not just the airbrush, but on everything. Especially when stuff costs that much money, right? So it's like, I can see when something is cheap, right? Sometimes they cut costs in order to, you know, packaging is not the most important thing. But once you start charging them expensive prices, it should all be pretty good. You're 51 years old. Oh man. Good luck, sir. I mean, I don't want to kill your dreams, but good luck. I started when I was very, very, very young, so it's, I have too much practice. And I make it look easy, but I think anybody in the chat that's tried this before will tell you it's not quite so easy. That's all I can really say is good luck. Especially at 51, man. I don't know, maybe you're in good shape at 51. I just know it's like a lot of finger control and like being real steady. I know a lot of old people I know are not very steady. It's easy with the right airbrush. Airton, you gotta be trolling. Cause yeah, bro, if you order a $600 airbrush, it'll make it so much easier. I'm gonna go with Air Todd on this one. Check to see if you can hear it, because it'll get flagged like right away, even if it's like whisper quiet. Oh, you paint and make sculptures. That's way better than airbrushing. Not gonna lie, I would watch some sculpture streams. I totally would. But you gotta be good. You gotta be good. You gotta be fast, because nobody wants to sit around and watch for hours and not see something get made. Even if it's something simple, I would watch that. I'm not gonna lie. That interests me. No?
No.
Okay. Okay, good. Thank you.
just gotta do the helmet up here. And do that. I don't know. I'm just gonna bring this down. Oh, there, Todd. I knew it, bro. I knew it. I read it, and I couldn't stop myself. It's like this is not real life. You have 13 Eclipse? Why do you have so many Eclipse? Were you airbrushing shirts, Todd? That sounds like you were airbrushing shirts. You have a 10-gun setup? Nice! Nice, dude. Why don't you paint more? I don't understand, Air Todd, bro. You're starting to concern me, man. You got all the airbrushes. You be subscribed and a member of every airbrush channel. You be sharing all the feeds, watching all of them. I know you be learning. Collecting airbrushes. Air Todd is collecting knowledge, is what he's doing. Yeah, airbrushing is like that. That's how it was for me. It was like learning how to write with a pencil all over again. I think that's another reason why I was so drawn to it. So I like stuff that's hard to do, that's just like, it's just like a challenge, really. My mind is like, no, fuck no. I have to be able to do this. If everybody else can do it, I could do it. Like, that's my brain at work. It's like, there's no such thing as failure. Right? Whether it takes me 1 year to learn, 5 years to learn, 10 years to learn, I'm gonna learn. And it did. It took me a long time to learn and a lot of dang practice. I went through like literal gallons of paint, like learning and just reading books. You guys are lucky. You guys are so lucky. I don't even understand. Just, you guys get free videos. Not just videos, but like free videos. There's lots of information out now. Nowadays, you know, about airbrushing and how to do it. Back then, it was hard. And then, like, not every store carried, like, Airbrush Action Magazine. It was a very, very niche magazine. And that's probably why it's not around anymore. But I think they should have just gone all digital, which would have made more sense to me, but whatever. But yeah, like, I learned out of books. That's how I learned how to airbrush. So nowadays it's like, man, you have no excuse. Like, there's video after video after video. You can watch people airbrush up the wazoo and probably still suck after a while. Yeah, I mean, everybody gets to find their thing, Steven, so... Garden stuff's pretty nice. I like keeping plants because it helps, like, relax every now and once in a while. You just go out there, you know, it helps you keep peace. Yeah, that's pretty much all I did in my free time too before. Specifically around the time when I was trying to learn to airbrush, I did not have like video games. I didn't have a TV. Yeah, it was a rough time. So it was like I had an airbrush, I had a little tiny compressor, and I had a job. So most of my, you know, little hard-earned dollars at that time, you know, either went to partying with friends, which I won't lie, I did a lot of partying with friends, you know, high school days, but also when I wasn't partying with friends, the rest of my budget was going towards, you know, buy this for painting and buy that for painting and, you know. All right, right on, Air Todd. Thank you, sir. Yeah, thank God for YouTube. No, no lie, John Moore, for sure. This is also true that sharing knowledge has like a double-edged sword, because then there's people who take the little knowledge you show, right, and then they run with it, and then they think they're masters, right? But then as soon as a problem arises, you know, then they are kind of lost. And I see a lot of videos or a lot of comments especially where it's like, I started this and this happened, what do I do? Or, you know, in the Facebook groups, I see this a lot too, where, you know, you could tell somebody's been in a Facebook group for a while and they've kind of been following along with the steps and this and that. And so then they decide to take on a project by themselves, and then they start having issues. And then the amount of different advice in the comments, you know, when somebody goes in there and asks for help. Some questions, it's pretty unison. The reply is, you know, pretty obvious. But sometimes, you know, and to me, it's like, it's a matter of that person should probably not have even done that project. You gotta kind of work yourself up to most projects. Right? Like, if you've never done a vehicle, right, it would probably be wise to do, like, maybe a metal panel or something first and then practice on that and then maybe do a bigger metal panel or maybe do a couple of metal panels and see if you could, like, match the quality. Something like that, you know. Same thing if you've never done a motorcycle. It might be a good idea to, like, actually do it on something first. Unless you're going to have somebody walk you through it, right? Because depending on how or where you learn, you know, you might be learning with another airbrush artist. And he might be willing to walk you through it, which that was kind of my case when it came to motorcycles and to some vehicles. Also, if you work like that at an automotive shop, a lot of times all you have to worry about is just the airbrush. They have a painter that takes care of the paint and everything. All you do is airbrush. Thing I'll tell everybody up front is don't get into it for the money. If you think, honestly, don't even think you're gonna make a living off of it, because you're probably not. The money from airbrushing is like in spurts, right? So you might get a motorcycle this month, maybe next month you get something different, maybe a different motorcycle. But there might be months, and yes, months, not weeks, there might be months where there might be nothing coming in. Again, it all depends on where you are, what you're doing, but being real, it's a possibility that you might go months without a single dollar made. So, is that a detail brush? This is the Iwata Revolution CR. I don't know what you qualify as a detail brush. Oh, you're watching a show. Cool. You just got your HD stencils. Any tips on the stencils when doing them on the guitar? So I would refer to the HD stencils videos. Make sure you go and watch their videos. They have videos on how to apply them and stuff. Other than that, it's pretty much like a basic stencil. It just has a lot of detail. So good luck. They are honestly amazing, amazing stencils. Yeah, nice cup. It's my wife's cup, bro. She got this for Mother's Day. Don't make fun of me, dude. I asked for some coffee. This is what she gave me, all right?
It's warm still, isn't it?
Mm-mm.
Oh.
No, but it's empty.
I can't find my robe.
Can't find your what? You feel lost even after watching somebody. Nice cup. Yeah, I you're all good, James. I know. Not my choice of cup, bro. That's all I gotta say. I can't even hate on that joke, because that was... I deserve it after she handed it to me. She should have known. Yeah, only one person, but still, one person's enough. Why are you handing me a pink cup? That's all I gotta say.
It's pretty.
It is pretty. I don't even care. I was wearing a pink shirt on the stream yesterday. Nobody said shit, so. Alright, so we got all that in there. Now, how do we want to play the background?
Back up.
A Montana black bass. Cool. I don't know what Montana black is. I like watching a lot of airbrush artists, not gonna lie, Steven. I like watching a lot of airbrush artists. Sometimes they make me angry because I'm with you. Like, they be explaining something and they'll either leave steps out, not show it, or something they said does not match up with what is happening on the screen. And yeah, sometimes I'm just like, what the freak is going on in this video? Why are they hiding it, bro? I think there needs to be more people that do it live, man. That also don't take all day. Like I don't mind watching a 2-hour stream, you know, letting it play in the back while I'm doing something or something. But like, sometimes those streams is like 2 hours, but nothing got done. Nothing, dude. Like, it's like the same painting as when they started is still there. What is the best way to learn airbrushing? Lots of practice. Alright, so now we got all that in there. Let's go ahead and... What's up, Dennis?
How's work, man? I hope work's doing good. I'm glad you're back at work, bro. Don't even worry about missing the stream or nothing. I'm glad you're back at work, dude. I just hope it's all safe. I hope you're doing good. Capture the light on this one is wicked. Thank you. Yeah, that's good, man. Good. Makes me glad to hear, Dennis.
What's up, Tattoo? I'm doing good, man. Thank you, Ellie. Thank you, thank you. I wonder if the powers that be will come up with a Rona Memorial Day. Oh, man. Yeah, you gotta stay confident in those strokes. I'm not gonna lie, confidence does help a little bit. Dennis has the fishing line out. Oh, that's funny. Before we do these stars real quick and everything, I'm just gonna go back and touch up some of this stuff. stove. Cool. Now we just do the white on these stars. Some to learn and some to try harder, huh? That's good. It's good that I could push you to do better, man. I always try to push myself, so if I rub off even a little bit on you, that's good, because it's the only way airbrushing will just progress. That is if we all collectively get better. Not just some of us, not just the ones hoarding information, or keeping it secret, or keeping it behind a paywall. This painting here, again, this is not an order for anybody. This is just my salute today, doing an artistic salute to all the service members, especially those that have, you know, sacrificed everything. And by everything, I mean the only thing that really matters, which is your life. And every single service member has sacrificed some of their life, because even just sacrificing years of your life to serve is a sacrifice. And you know, so this painting is for you guys. I hope, you know, I hope you guys enjoy it. And when I post the picture, right, make sure all of you share it, make sure it gets around, so that all these veterans and all these service members can go ahead and enjoy it, you know? Not just the airbrush community, but all of them. So, again, I thank you for all your service. I hope this small painting provides you some kind of enjoyment, satisfaction, whatever it is it brings you. I hope it can bring you a little bit of something and let you know that I thank you and you're very welcome, and I wish the government did more for you, honestly. That's pretty good right there. Yep, I muted the flag in the background, kind of kept it mostly gray so that we could really enjoy the detail of the rest of the painting there. See that right there? That is how you do a battlefield cross. You don't take all day on it, but you still make it look amazing. And we'll try to make this a tradition every year, Memorial Day. We'll start it this year, and every year on Memorial Day, we'll try to do, you know, a painting for all our soldiers out there. Whether it's in the US, whether you're fighting for the Mexican forces, whatever it is, obviously, I'm in the U.S., so I'm going to do a U.S. flag. But all of you out there, you know, we're all just protecting our families, protecting our land, doing the best we can. And know that, you know, it means a lot to me. It means a lot to my family. You know, I'm happy none of my cousins and family ever got killed in battle, but I appreciate them all going. I probably would have gone too. I've gone over this story a bunch of times. But yeah, you guys don't need to hear that. Today is about them. Remember them. Thank all of them. And yeah. Anyway, guys, that'll wrap it up for today. I hope you guys enjoyed that. I'll go ahead and post a picture on social media for everybody to enjoy. Again, make sure you go and you share that out. And thank you guys all for watching. What's up, Richard Gray? Thank you, sir, for your service. What's up, Tats, Heather, Air Todd, Steven, Dennis? Who else showed up? I gotta go up in the chat here. Let's see. Who else showed up today? Richard Gray, Dennis, Steven, Air Todd, of course. How could I forget Air Todd? Allie Lopez, Heather, Yvonne, Derek Coleman, Grovlight. I hope I said your name wrong. James Melton. Everybody that showed up today, even if you just showed up just to watch and you didn't actually like say anything in the chat, that's cool with me too. Whatever. But anyway, I'll get out of you guys' hair. Everybody enjoy the rest of your night. Happy Memorial Day to everybody. And even though, you know, our country's in pandemic and we got a president that doesn't seem to care and all that stuff, you know that I love the country and I would do anything for the country, including wearing a fucking mask for the store. So be safe, everybody, and we'll see y'all next time. By next time, I mean tomorrow. So later, everybody. Good night.